Hey guys, welcome back to it, another fresh episode on wireless technology. So in today's video, let's see the power management concept which is there in the IEEE 802.11 WLAN systems. So in the previous video, we saw what was synchronization and how synchronization mainly happened in the infrastructure network as well as the ad hoc network. So in today's video, let's mainly concerned regarding the most important feature which is there in the wireless systems. That is, we have the power management. So let's begin. So when power management terms comes into picture, the first and foremost thing in wireless devices is the battery life with that particular device. So whenever you purchase a smartphone, the first and most important thing which would come to your mind is the battery backup, that for how many hours you can use this device or use this smartphone for the entire day. So in WLAN systems, mainly the primary goal is to keep one device which is not in use. So this device is always open all the time. So this is called as a transceiver. So you have one device that is sending devices, and there are n number of transceivers. So that is called as a transceiver. So this transceiver is open all the time. So that device you need to just keep awake only when it is required. Now there are two devices which mainly participates in the picture of power management. That is, you have the sending device and then you have the receiving device. So just consider, this is an example, like you have a shopkeeper and there are some customers. So that customers or the customers of that particular shop would be coming at some random time. So there is no particular fixed fashion that when that customer would be coming to that shop. But that shopkeeper should physically remain at that place, and he should stay awake and he should be alive at all the time, so that the customers can be served at the proper time. So that can be said over here. So the sending device, in that the transmission happens self-prompted. So it is the customer's desire, or if that customer wishes to come at this particular shop, then he will come. If he does not wish to come, he will not come. So that simple as that. And the receiving device wakes up and stays awake periodically. So each and every day, that is 24/7, he has to go to that shop, physically open that shop and to be present there in order to serve the customers. Now, mainly the switching process which happens in the power management should be transparent to the underlying protocols in WLAN systems, whatever it is used. For example, say if it's TCP/IP or DHCP or other some protocols which are there, so they should be aware about what kind of switching mechanism is basically happened in this. So if they don't know or what kind of switching process is done in this, then they cannot efficiently handle the switching process and this goes a flaw. So this process, if you employ it very properly, then it can save your battery life. Obviously the battery life would be increased, but at the cost of reducing the average throughput. So the average throughput of that device would reduce and the battery backup or the battery life would get increased. Now every device has got two states, that is, in power saving you have got two states for receivers as well as the senders. So in receivers you have the sleep as well as the awake, whereas in senders you have something called as data buffering. So now we mainly talk about the senders. Now if the station, that is STA, is sleeping, then the sending device must dash the data. Now for example, say this is a sending device and if there is station 1, station 2 and station 3. Now all these three devices are sleeping, or all these three stations are sleeping. So sending device can communicate with this or this or this. So it should have the necessary data kept at some buffer or kept at some queue. So for that it must buffer this particular kind of data as and when required. Now this sleeping station periodically wakes up and checks and stay awake for a specific period of time. Now this could be for 5 minutes, this could be for 10 minutes, this could be for 20 minutes. So they have their particular time as and when they will get up and awake and will check whether any particular packet is coming to them or not. So all the sending devices broadcast their destinations for their buffered data frame. So it's like each of the sending device would be having some particular address, or if say this packet 1 is for station 1, then it would be assigned to that particular station. So for that the station if it's found as a destination of a particular buffered packet, then it has to remain awake until this transfer happens. So it has to remain awake for 5 minutes until this packet has been successfully transferred to that particular station. To wake up at the right time, in case of us also, if we want to wake up at the proper time, or if we want to go to office, or if we want to go to college or school, we keep an alarm. But in WLAN systems, what we use is we have a TSF, that is a timing synchronization function, which is used from the synchronization concept. And so it majorly is kept up and running at the sleeping station. So this TSF is usually found at the sleeping station, that is STA1, STA2 and STA3. Now in this, AP majorly transmits the beacon frame. So this is same as a synchronization. So in synchronization, you majorly had this beacon. But along with this beacon, in power management, you have something called as the TIM, that is the traffic indication map. Traffic indication map, which is there exclusively kept for power management. So now what this TIM basically has? So TIM basically has a record for all the stations which AP buffers unicast data frames, means it has only one particular form of data for that particular data frame. Now the sleeping station wakes up and start listening to your beacon. Now it has to listen to both beacon as well as the TIM, so that it will get to know at what time or what all data frames it has been processed. Now if the TIM buffered the unicast frame for STA, now if this is successful, then this particular station should remain awake for any multicast or any broadcast transmission. Why? Because if there is a broadcast transmission, then it could be from any of the station, or station 2 or station 3 or any other end station. So it should be kept awake, like what kind of data it is going to get. So well, that was all regarding the power management in the IEEE 802.11 WLAN system. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you got educated for this video, please do like, share, comment, and if you are new to this channel, please consider subscribing. Thank you very much for watching this video.